Can you stand? Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and the living. We brought nothing into this world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms.
With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our sister Linda for burial. Our sister was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise her to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our sister, Linda. We thank you for giving her to us, her family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth, until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The opening hymn, Through All the Changing Scenes of Life. Kindly be seated for the eulogy by Ms. Faye Taylor.
Good morning, church. Linda Yvette Gibson was born to the late Cynthia Polly Gibson and Livingston Gibson on June the 9th, 1972 in the USA. She was the granddaughter of Joseph and Alma Larrier and was educated in New York and Barbados. On Tuesday, I went by Larner's home as usual and had a conversation with her son Ishmael. So what I'm going to say now are the things Ishmael told me about his mom. Ishmael said that his mom was a no-nonsense person. No one could mess with her children. He also stated that when he was a boy, he's a man now, when he was a boy, a very young boy, he said a youth, his mom used to take them on picnics. And his favorite place was the beach. He also stated that his mom used to take them in town every Saturday, and she would walk quite quickly so that he would have to run and catch up with them, looking back at them all the time and smiling. So that was a game for them. He also stated that when they got back from the picnic or the beach, his mom used to put his younger brother, Ian, in the bar, him, Ishmael, on the handle, and rode them down to his great-grandmother's house, Mama, as we call her. Linda had, as you all know, two children, Ishmael, as I just spoke about, and Ian, who died tragically. Because of Ian's death, Linda mourned for Ian all during her life. So that on his birthday, she used to take his niece, nephews, on a picnic to celebrate Ian's birthday. Linda liked traveling. She liked cruising. And Ishmael said one time she took him on the Harbor Master. Linda was a very talented person. Linda was a very respectful person. And she encouraged her two boys to be very, very respectful. Linda loved elderly people, and she also loved dogs. Every time my dog had puppies, one was to be for Linda. She was very compassionate, as I said before. She was very loving. She was very soft-spoken. But she knew what she wanted for her son, Ishmael. She was very proud of him when he graduated from Dighton Griffith. And there were always conversations and laughing and talking all the time. Linda, the last time I visited Linda in the hospital, we realized that Linda's speech was perfect because everybody knew she had a slight speech impediment and her speech was perfect. When we came up in the car, we were so excited. We said, oh dear, Linda's getting better. So my good friend Lorna went home, along with Susan, cleaned the bedroom that was already cleaned because we were so sure that Linda was coming to her earthly home. But that was not to be. God had other plans for her. Linda left her brother Joseph and John. She loved John, but she had a favorite spot for Ishmael. For Joey. Yeah, Joey. She used to wash his clothes. She used to clean his room. And when God's son came up, she was the one, our goddaughter, somebody whispered to me, came up. She was the one who looked after the godson or the goddaughter while Joey went on his business. We know that Joey is going to miss her a lot. She leaves to mourn her two brothers, I said, John and Joey. Linda also leaves to mourn her aunts and her uncles. Lorna, let me give you a little something about Lorna. We were coming up from the beach when Lorna got the message that something was wrong with Linda. We all know that Lorna is a very careful driver. But that morning, I think Lorna would have won the race at Bushy Park. We came up the road. Linda, and then Lorna was always there with Linda. She encouraged her at an hospital. When we realized that we thought Linda was getting better, she decided to get her friend Suzette to come and clean the room that was already cleaned, because we were sure that Linda was coming home. Lorna loved Linda, and Linda loved Lorna. Lorna is small in stature, as you can see, but she's very resilient and trustworthy. She also leaves to mourn Brenda and Aubrey, Evelyn and Victor, Heather and Sydney, plus all the extended family. Our heartfelt thanks goes to all of you who were kind enough to send messages and were there for Lorna and the family while Linda was ill. Lorna helped to wipe away Linda's tears when she was in the hospital and was always giving her positive thoughts, positive things to think about. Linda worried about her son Ishmael. But we know that Ishmael is in very, very good hands. Okay. Our heartfelt thanks go to her lifelong partner, Danny. I don't see him, but I know he's here somewhere. Danny? Okay, there he is. Who was a source of strength, dedication, and commitment. His love for Linda was exceptional. Danny brought a host of jewelry to be put on Linda when she died. He could not hold on Linda. He visited her every day in the hospital, and he spent his night talking to her on the phone and encouraging her. We thank you, Danny, for your support, for your commitment, and for your love. He also was there to wipe the tears away from Linda's eyes every night. The Larry family thanks you, and the Gibson family also thank you. All the memories that we, and Ishmael especially, have for his mom, those we love never leave us. For their beautiful memories are imprinted in our hearts forever. Lorna will never read a poem.
Remembering you is easy. We'll do it every day. Missing you is the heartache that will never go away. When ties of life are broken and loved ones have a part, it leaves a wound only God can heal. But we'll look back with memories upon the road we trod. We bless the years we had with you and leave the rest to God. Thank you.
Thank you. Heavenly Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us your true faith and your sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. We now have the first Bible reading.
Good morning to all. a reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Revelation, the 21st chapter, beginning at the first verse. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with him. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children." The word of the Lord.
The psalm is number 23, the Cremon version. The congregation is invited to stand for the psalm. Kindly be seated for the second Bible reading.
Good morning, everyone. A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of John, the 14th chapter, beginning at the first verse. Do not let your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. The word of the Lord.
The hymn before the sermon, Loving Shepherd of Thy Sheep.
Please be seated. First, allow me on behalf of Father David Yard, the priest in charge here at St. Martin and the church family here, to express sincerest condolences to Linda's family and friends at this time of their bereavement. We may be assured of the continued prayers of the church. And as you say your goodbyes to your loved one this morning, I want us to reflect for a few moments on the hope that is found in the words attributed to Jesus in the third verse of the reading you just heard, the 14th chapter of the Gospel according to John, words which tell us, let not your hearts be troubled, believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. Friends, if we only look at life at the surface level, we would probably conclude that people are born and after some measure of time, they die. But for Christians, there's in fact much more to this life than just living and dying. For Christians have a hope that there's something greater in store for us, something beyond this life, which at times seems to be filled with troubles and sorrows. And often in the sadness and alongside the deep sense of loss that we experience when a loved one dies, we block out the fact that Jesus told us not to be troubled. And furthermore, he also promised his disciples on the night before his death on the cross that he was going to prepare a place for them, and by extension, us, so that when he comes again, he will take us to be with him. For instead of being preoccupied with his own troubles, which were right in front of him, his concern was for his disciples. He wanted them to understand that even though he would be leaving them physically, his absence was for a greater cause. He wanted them to understand that he wasn't leaving them just for leaving them sake, but that he was going to prepare a place for them. But friends, while this reassurance was first given to the disciples on that fateful Thursday night nearly 2,000 years ago, the message of Jesus' words is still clear and is in essence still one that is intended for us today. Jesus has gone to prepare a place for us. Now some of us may call this place heaven, and some of us may call it home. But regardless of the name we give to the place that Jesus has gone to prepare for us, it is a place that we should all give some thought to while we still live and breathe and walk this earth. For in the same way that we like to plan for business trips or holiday trips overseas, this place is going to be the final place we must head to, not for a temporary visit, but for a permanent stay. And we should always be packed and ready for it, since we have no idea when we will leave. You know how we sometimes leave our childhood home and build our own homes and start our own families. But then every time we return to visit our parents, we say that we are going down home or going up home. Well, leaving this earth to be with Jesus in the place he has prepared for us, it would be like going home to a place we are already familiar with, except that we will not leave because it is our Father's house and we belong there. So friends, even though people die every day, when we lose our loved ones, it is never an easy experience because we never get used to it. But in Jesus, we have strength and we can find comfort. In Jesus, we have a hope and a friend who has gone before us to prepare a place for us. And if we choose to be with him, we will have a friend who will welcome us home when it is our turn to leave this earth. Friends, the creator of this world sent his son to die for us. And after his resurrection, he left to go and prepare a place for us and for all our loved ones who have gone before us. But only if we make the choice to be with him. Just try to imagine what that place must be like. For if we think that this world is beautiful, then I do not think that we can even begin to imagine what our final home will be like. After all, God is the original architect. God is the original artist. There is none better. And what an assurance Jesus' promise must have been to the frightened disciples. For even though their friend, their teacher, and their Lord was leaving, he was going to return and take them to be with him. And what an assurance that promise is for us today as well. For we also have this same blessed hope that he is coming back for us, even though we do not know when that time will be. But we know that we can trust his promises. Now, friends and family of Linda, you have done a good thing in seeking to celebrate and give thanks for Linda's life this morning. For even though your hearts may break as you mourn the physical loss of this young woman from your lives, there is indeed at the same time another wonderful truth. Linda has returned to her Creator. And because we believe that we will be given a new body after our death, which will not be subjected to the illnesses and pains and troubles that we know and experience in this present life, you can be assured that there's a place as described in the first reading from the Revelation to John where death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away. For as the Apostle Paul said in his second letter to the Corinthians, if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, an eternal house in heaven, not built by human hands. Or in other words, this physical body that we all see and know will fade away for all of us, but we will be given new bodies so that we will be able to reside in the place that God has gone to prepare for us, a place where there will be no more arthritis, no more COVID-19, no more cancer, no more high blood pressure, no more headaches. For the place that Jesus has gone to prepare for us is a place where there will be no more night, no more pain, and no more tears. But death will be fought, swallowed up in victory, and death will lose its sting. Friends, Jesus is asking us to trust him, to have faith in him, even though we have never seen him. He has promised that he is coming back for us to take us to the place that he has gone to prepare. Linda has come to the end of her earthly journey. She has gone home. And even as we remember her and cherish the memories that remain, we must also understand that we too will one day make the transition from this mortal life. Let us therefore seek to inherit that place that he has gone to prepare for us. May Linda's soul rest in peace. Amen. Let us now stand and with confidence and hope confess the faith into which we were baptized as we say the Apostles' Creed found on page 5 of your leaflet. I believe in God, please remain standing for the prayers and commendation.
Intercessory is found on page 6 of your leaflet. Your response will be, hear our prayer. We pray for those who mourn. We commemorate the departed Linda. Let us pray with confidence to God our Father, who raised our Lord Jesus from the dead for the salvation of all. Grant, Lord, that your servant may know the fullness of life which you have promised to those who love you. Lord, in your mercy, be close to those who mourn. Increase their faith in your undying love. Lord, in your mercy, may we be strengthened in our faith live the rest of our lives in fellowship with your Son, and be ready when you call us to the fullness of life. Lord, in your mercy, show your mercy to the dying, strengthen them with hope, and fill them with the peace and joy of your presence. Lord, in your mercy, we commend all people to your unfailing love, that in them your will be fulfilled, and we rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we may share with them in your eternal kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Hear our prayer.
Father of all, we pray to you for Linda and for all those whom we love but see no longer. Grant them eternal rest. Let light perpetual shine upon them. May she and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints. Where sorrow and pain are no more.
Let the sign that life everlasting.
You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind. And we are mortal, formed of the earth. And to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created us, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Let us commend our sister Linda to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant, Linda, O Sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set her free from every bond, that she may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Linda. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen.
The hymn number 349, There Was Joy in Heaven, and as your booklet indicates, it doesn't. Yes, during the singing of this hymn, a collection will be taken for the upkeep of the church. There was joy in heaven.
There was joy in heaven.
Then now Demetis. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and giving life to those in the tomb. The Son of Righteousness is gloriously risen, giving light to those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. The Lord will guide our feet into the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom of heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, "Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you into paradise. May angels lead you, Linda. At your coming, may the martyrs receive you and bring you into that holy city, Jerusalem. The Lord be with you. Let's just get the attention. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence, there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this. Happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you.
In sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Linda, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this, our sister Linda, and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, raise us, we humbly pray, from the death of sin to the life of righteousness, that when we depart this life, we may find rest in him, and at the resurrection receive that blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come, you blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our Mediator and Redeemer.
Amen.
Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved, the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Rest eternal grant to her, O Lord.
And let light perpetual shine upon her.
May she and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
the hymn, O Love That Will Not Let Me Go.
Oh,
Let us pray. Father of all, by whose mercy and grace your saints remain in everlasting light and peace, we remember with thanksgiving Linda, whom we love but see no longer. And we pray that in her your perfect will may be fulfilled through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace, both now and forevermore.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us depart in peace.
In the name of
God be with you till we meet again. By his counsels guide uphold you. With his sheep securely fold you. God be with you till we meet again.
Failing well.